Alright, so welcome to episode 2 of CrossFit Corner. Today, I want to tackle a little bit more in depth on the shoulder. We're going to talk about stability and motor control problems of the shoulder compared to mobility problems of the shoulder. Alright, so Craig here is an example of someone who has excellent shoulder mobility, but when he lifts his arm, you're going to lift your arm up as high as you can, he gets stuck right about there. So the question would be, does he need to work more on mobility or does he need to work more on strength and accessing his available range of motion? So we're gonna find out by getting him on the table, and this is something that you guys can do at home in the gym as well. So go ahead and lay down on your back. The main way to tell and to decipher between a motor control problem and a mobility problem is to compare your active range of motion, which is how much you can move it on your own with your own muscles, compared to passive range of motion, which is where someone else would move whatever joint that we're talking about. They would move that for you as much as the joint allows it to happen. So with Craig here, if I take control, so let me try to make his shoulders as loose as possible. If I take Craig through a full flexion range of motion of his shoulder, he actually has excellent range of motion, right? So there's plenty of availability there for him to access that overhead position. But what we saw when he stood is that he could only access about that much of it. And so that's one of the key differentiators to find out what he should target with his training. In his case, it would be more strengthening exercises, more stability exercises to try to improve his shoulder function that way. All right, so Katie here is an example of someone who has a true mobility problem, and we're gonna kind of take a look at that. So Katie, go ahead and lift your arm above your head, and she gets stuck right there. And so go ahead and lay down on your back, Katie. This is a little bit of a different scenario where passively, what we expect to find is that she reaches about the same barrier when I move her arm forward. So we're able to go slightly further than what she was able to access when she was in a standing position, but she still gets stuck about the same spot as before. And so this would be someone who truly has a mobility problem, where things like joint mobilization, soft tissue work, working with a PT to get some hands-on care would be more appropriate. Hopefully you found this helpful. If you did, drop me a like, comment, let me know what else you'd like to learn about. Have a great day.